early 90s when our first star joined the biggest boy band since the Osmonds. They were New Kids on the Block. He is Jordan Knight.
New Kids on the Block sold over 50 million albums. They had 6 top 10 hits in a row. Jordan's debut album went gold in America.
Jordan Knight, 18 years old.
Don't let all the screaming girls make you believe you're God.
Always down to earth and surprisingly modest, our Jordan knew a thing or two about fan mania. He was 1/5 of the 90s super boy band New Kids on the Block.
The best group in the entire world.
We're like how Brass is over here, over in the United States.
Or the Beatles.
Well, not quite the Beatles.
But it was lead vocalist Jordan Knight who was the fans' number one, and they let him know it.
The award for best dressed and most fanciable males. I want to thank all you fine English girls.
The New Kids were massive. In the UK alone, they notched up 8 top 10 singles and 3 albums before disbanding in 1994. Then it was time to go solo. There were plenty of Howard Donalds in New Kids, but Jordan was truly their Robbie and returned with a great track. But hold on a minute. That outfit, that cigarette, haven't we seen this somewhere before? You better shape up. Yes, he's shaped up, but one thing stays the same, that pelvic thrust. Calm yourselves, girls, because tonight he's back.
From way back in 1999. How did it feel stepping on stage without the rest of the band?
At first it was a bit scary, but I'm kind of used to it now. Thanks to all the fans out there.
You've still got a whole bunch of fans. Yeah. Now, what was the highlight of being in New Kids on the Block?
I would say like traveling all around the world and coming to Europe and Britain and going to Japan and just, you know, seeing the rest of the world.
Basically. And enjoying yourself. And what track are you going to do for us later?
I'm going to do Mario, Let Me Love You.
Put your hands together for Mr. Jordan Knight. I'm getting that Shaky Stevens vibe from in the studio. Now, still to come.